And they're custom made for us. So you notice the glass size is exactly to our specifications. Yeah, so we get them custom made. And they're 2K by 1K resolution.
Okay.
And they're touchscreen, of course.
Yeah. So,
and that's the.
So you've got quite a team of people. So someone's got to design all the graphics and the GUI. And
so we've got quite a big team.
Yeah. And you subcontract most of it.
No, we've got largely full time.
Yeah. Okay.
A few of them part time.
So part full time people, you've got.
So
six or eight.
Mainly software. At the moment, we've got about six people on software, and two on hardware.
That's quite an investment.
But where we're lucky is that Classtech do all the production stuff and quality stuff. That's where it used to cost a lot to do that yourself in the house. But they can scale. So if we say we only want to run 60 units at the moment, or I can do 200 next month, it's not a problem.
Yeah.
You can do volume control. Got a headphone outlet, you can just put its own headphone out.
God.
Input streaming XLR phono, da da da. Go back to home. Yeah.
Beautiful.
Profile.
How does the streaming work? What platform have you used there?
We're using Volumio here, so we can do Tidal, Cubase.
Yep, right here.
We'll do AirPlay
on
your phone or Bluetooth.
Okay.
So really, these days,
even Bluetooth,
you don't really need any other inputs.
No. It's such a nice. Am I getting any?
No, you're in the.
Good knob feel.
Yeah.
Tactile.
Well, smooth.
Mm.
Has a good, I was going to say Swiss feel, but what I really meant is Australian feel.
I think, I think so.
Yes. No, that's great. And it's, I guess there's no points for making something that's pretty on the inside, but it is. And, very nicely crafted. And this is made in this building.
Yes, it's assembled here, and the circuit boards are assembled in Mascot.
Yeah, okay.
It's
as local product as it could be.
It's very local.
Yeah.
It's totally impressive, isn't it?
Absolutely.
That's my impressed look. Well, I am. I mean, it's just...
it's gorgeous.
It's just amazing. What's kind of annoying is it's so hard to make a decent loudspeaker cabinet in this country, but we can make this no worries at all.
Very true, Andrew. Albeit though, you're one of the few that can make a decent cabinet.
Well, maybe but in small limited quantities.
Yeah. But no, it's stunning.
And the lid comes off just with a couple of screws.
Two screws.
Oh, hell, just a delight.
Yeah, because there's adjustments inside you can make to gain analog output gains and things like that.
Oh, okay, right. Yeah.
Typically, you don't need to, but if people have, for instance, if your sensitivity of your drivers and you're doing an active system and your tweeters are 10 dB more sensitive than, say, the mid-range, it's good if you can just wind down the analog gain.
Yes.
It'll do it. In the digital domain, no problem.
Yeah.
And the dynamic range of our DAX is so big that no one really is going
to
notice.
It'd be better to do
But theoretically, it's better to do it in the analog domain. So you can do a 6 dB attenuation or a 12 dB attenuation on every output.
Oh, so separately. A dip switch sort of thing? Or
it's a little link.
Nice.
That's great. So this is receiving, so like you say, a little bit of burn in.
Yeah,
we've run it up, letting it up to temperature.
Probably. Yeah, we've got 100 of these in the field already.
Yeah.
And they've been out for the last 6 months, a bit more than 6 months. Mm-hmm. So, but they're beta software.
Yes.
So the people who got them 6 months ago had a bit more of a struggle with the software than now. Now it's getting pretty good.
Well, they were, it was beta, so they knew they were going to have to back.
And for beta members, well, we have a special deal for anyone who wants to buy them now before mm-hmm. they're formally released.
Yeah.
And because we can sell them direct, so effectively it's
like wholesale.
And the only issue is that they're getting beta software.
Yes.
But by being a beta member, they can feed it back directly for us for any bugs they find.
Which is just great for you, obviously.
Yeah.
And so, well, you basically need that program, don't
well,
you?
Well, that's led to us doing some software changes in the design of the software, and that's why we've extended the beta program a bit, probably to Q1.
Just to shake all the bugs out.
Just to, yeah, and to add, well, also to click to add some new features in the
interface. Right, yeah.
So you can control everything from your phone,
you
know, your iPhone or whatever, because it's all, these days, everything's
network.
Yes.
So, yeah. So, yeah.
Absolutely world class. Now we've got over here, Brad. Kim was showing me earlier. Well, there's a pallet of casework there.
Yeah.
But Kim, do you want to describe what we've got here on the trolley?
Yeah. There's so these are just, for example, this is just the output, the balanced output module. So these have their own mute circuits on them. They've got their own gain links on each output. There'll be little links you can change there. Mm-hmm. So for every output, you can adjust the gain. The main board, this.
So this on these two trolleys is effectively the insides of X amount of pieces, obviously, because there seems to be lots of different.
So, so one unit would use one preamp. The pre four, which only has four outputs, just uses one.
Yeah,
of those.
Okay.
But it also has a digital output board and module, which actually is this one. That gives you SPDIF and AES3 digital outputs. Mm-hmm. It's isolated, transformer isolated. So that's on the pre fours. So that, for instance, for the person who has no intention of ever going active, they just want to use it with their main full range speaker, but they can add subwoofers, one or two subwoofers.
Yeah, okay.
These are little digital output modules. So these are, each one of these is a sample rate converter and an SPDIF transmitter. So you can upsample all the digital outputs on a pre-8 or a pre-4. If your DAC prefers, if you're using an external DAC, which really almost I don't know any of our users who are actually using.
But
they've tried them.
So
you can do it, and you can say, "Oh, would I rather use the?" This is actually what the panel is. That's the front panel board. That's also got a headphone amplifier there.
All right.
I'm looking at the underside, right? So there's the inputs there. That's the analog board at the top. That's the processor board underneath. That's the CPU is under that. The main CPU is under that heatsink. This is the XMOS board for USB input. That's the digital output module I just showed you.
So this, just for clarity, so that assembly that you've got there, which is sort of the most of the internals, so that's made 8 suburbs away.
No, we assemble them here. But
oh,
the,
you assemble
but the
that
blank
assembly
boards,
here, but the,
yeah, the blank boards
the robot
are,
picking and...
That's done at a company called OnTrack in Mascot.
Yeah. Do you want that brand in the video?
No, well, there are...
We can pixelate that.
We can pixelate that.
Yeah, there
are... The point is that they are building the boards.
So that's, for instance, what...
Are they printing the boards
does.
Here, or the boards printed in Honkers or somewhere?
No, the boards we do get made at a place we've been using for 40 years in China.
Yep.
Because they just do such a
they're
fantastic
just so good,
job. Yep. We never have a problem.
Yeah,
literally... Never had a problem with boards.
So blank boards from China.
Australia really is not good at making.
No, I can't find anyone who can make a good board. Yeah. So, well, they don't have the technology that clearly China has got, and it's so inexpensive, it's kind of ridiculous.
Yeah.
And the job is so good. But the loading of the parts is done in Sydney.
Yes.
Yeah. And then what's soldering? Is that then kind of just baked, or what's the soldering regime?
It's a standard reflow system. Yeah, it goes through a conveyor belt through an oven.
Yep.
It's all very temperature controlled, and everything just melts.
Yeah, so everything's loaded on the board. The board's sort of tinned with solder. The parts get glued glued on effectively.
Well, what happens first is the board has what's called a solder mask which is a stencil.
Yes. Yeah.
And then you use effectively silk screen all this solder paste, which has the solder in it as well.
Yeah, yeah.
And that way the components just sit on it, and when it goes through the oven, everything gels reflows, together, and miraculously it works.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm always impressed that
In the old days, you'd get a board out of the system, and you'd get two out of 50 working.
Right.
Yeah. Oh, is that right?
These days,
you're talking 20 years ago or more, though.
Yeah. These days, it's virtually 100% straight off the production.
Because the temperatures involved in that reflow process are quite high, aren't they?
Yeah.
I mean, 270 or something.
I can't tell you the exact
number. But the components obviously go,
all the components are specified to be machine soldered.
Mm.
So they're designed to be able to cope with
that. But then they're only suffering it for, I guess it's 5 seconds or something like that.
For through-hole components, because they're going through a solder wave, that lasts not very long,
no,
and it is a bit hotter.
Yes.
When they go through the oven, that's quite a lengthy time.
Yeah. Okay, so the whole thing heats up. It's
certainly a lot more than 5 seconds.
Yeah, so more like a minute and 5 seconds.
I can't tell the exact time, but didn't that all work?
But it works. The whole point is that and the hit rate, success rate is virtually 100%.
That's right.
Yeah. Totally impressive.
So that's all good.
So Kim, what have we got here?
So this is a black preamp, which is one of the, this is the flagship generation 4 products. So
right.
I've just taken the screws off the back so I can get the
lid off. And you're currently burning it in?
So yeah, we burn them in for about three days.
Okay.
And inside is the circuit boards. There's about another three boards under these. This board here, that's
right.
The main analog board, DAC board, balanced output module, streaming module. There's another processor, another two processors underneath
right.
these circuit boards. Dynavector made us a custom Fairlight preamp.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Jonathan Davies, yeah.
Exactly. So if I turn it around, you'll notice we have the, this can do four-way, you can use this with a passive traditional
right.
speaker,
right.
in which case you just use those outputs, what we call the bass channel out.
Yeah.
So, but if you want to do an active speaker, that's subwoofer, bass, mid-range, tweeter, you've got digital outs for all of those as well, in case you want to use your favourite DACs.
Yeah.
Although you will not get a better DAC than ours anyway, so that was really a waste of time.
That's handy, though.
Yeah, yeah. So, and we've also got unbalanced outs for all of these. This is the inputs. We've got USB audio in, a couple of Toslink digitals, SPDIF, AES3 digital in. Microphone input, which is all systems come with our calibration microphone for doing room measurements, and also speaker calibration if you want to do that. And then balanced line in, unbalanced line ins, photo in stuff.
So you've thought of everything.
So it's quite a lot in there. And a network connection, of course, for your streaming.
Yeah.